So earlier you learned about interpolation. It's the double curly braces syntax we use to display data. So here we have two examples. One is for rendering the title field, and the other is for the image URL. And with this template, we get something like this. Now, this interpolation is just a syntactical sugar. Behind the scene, when Angular compiles our templates, it translates these interpolations into what we call property binding. With property binding, we bind a property of a DOM element, like source here, to a field or a property in our component. Now, let me show you the syntax for using property binding. I'm going to rewrite the second example, but instead of using interpolation, I'm going to use property binding. So image, I want to bind the source property. So I put it between square brackets, source, and for the value I use the title field of courses component. Note that here we don't have double curly braces. So when we use double curly braces or string interpolation, Angular behind the scene translates that into the second syntax. And with this, whenever the value of the title field changes, the source attribute of this image element is automatically updated. Now here you might have a question. You might be wondering whether you should use string interpolation or the square bracket syntax. Well, interpolation works well for adding dynamic values between headings, like here between the H2 element. Or if you're using divs, spans, paragraphs, or wherever you want to render text, that's when you use string interpolation. In this example, if I want to use property binding with this H2 heading, look what I have to write. So, H2. Now I have to bind the text content property of H2 DOM element. I have to bind this to the title field of the courses component. Obviously, you can see the second syntax is longer and more noisy. So that's why I prefer to use string interpolation wherever I want to add text between headings, paragraphs, divs, and spans. In other cases, you can see the property binding syntax using the square brackets is actually shorter. Now, there is nothing wrong with using string interpolation here, but the second syntax is cleaner and shorter. Now, the syntax aside, one thing you need to know about property binding is that it works only one way, from component to the DOM. So if these fields in the component change, Angular will update the DOM. But any changes in the DOM are not reflected back in the component. So if we add an input field here, and the user types something in the input field, the underlying property or field in the component will not be updated. We have two-way binding for that, and I will explain that later in this section.